Subscribe now, hit the notification bell, and be ready to embark on a visual adventure. Prepare for an inside and out investigation of the new Volvo EX30. We'll cover its key elements, execution, and how it piles facing its ancestors, including the Volvo EX30 2023. State-of-the-art plan and inside, wonder about the smooth plan and investigate the modern inside of the Volvo EX30. From cutting-edge control boards to agreeable lodges, this machine is planned in light of both usefulness and administrator solace. Electric unrest, find the eco-accommodating side of development with the Volvo EX30 Electric. We'll dig into its electric engine capacities, manageability highlights, and how it's making ready for a greener future. Test drive insight, go along with us for an intriguing test drive as we take the Volvo EX30 out on the field. Experience its power, accuracy, and mobility firsthand. We could try and toss in a POV, perspective, test drive for a vivid encounter. Execution measurements, numbers don't lie. We'll separate the details, including the noteworthy 428-pull motor. Figure out how the Volvo EX30 2024 beats the opposition and sets another norm in the business. One engine, more reach. Each Volvo EX30 that shows up on US streets will be controlled by a 69 kWh battery pack, 64 kWh net usable. However, forthcoming proprietors will have their pick of two electric engine setups. The single engine expanded range arrangement utilizes, you got it, a solitary 200 kilowatt engine driving the back tires to the tune of 268 pull and 253 pound-feet of force. Italy Electric slide its direction from 0 to 60 miles per hour in 5.1 seconds, or it can journey for up to 275 miles of reach, contingent upon how forceful you are with the gas pedal. On Spanish roadways around Barcelona, I observed that I was more than content with the degree of execution presented by the single engine. The directing is a piece light and overboosted for my taste, however the EX30 actually feels dexterous and exact around twists and precipitous bends. Like most EVs, it is bounty lively at moderate in and out of town speeds and, on the throughway, it was a quiet and genuinely certain cruiser. I arrived at the midpoint of 3.15 miles per kilowatt hour during my brief time frame in the driver's seat, yet I don't really accept that the distance voyaged was sufficient for a precise proficiency gauge. Twin engine execution adds power. The move up to the twin engine execution spec adds a second engine to the front pivot, adding all-wheel drive sure-footedness and bringing the all-out power result to 315 kilowatts, or 422 strength. With 400 pound-feet of force good to go, and its battery pack essentially 80% condition of charge, the twin engine EX30 will run to 60 miles per hour in 3.4 seconds, procuring it the honor of speediest creation Volvo yet. Driven with a light foot, the twin engine spec doesn't feel fundamentally not quite the same as its single engine kin because of the powertrain consequently decoupling the front pivot under light loads and cruising to boost reach and productivity. Handling my tried normal at 3.70 miles/kWh or inside a safety buffer of the past model. Nonetheless, the extra weight of the double engine framework and the discretionary 20-inch wheels on our model accompany reach punishment, dropping to 265 assessed miles for each charge. Discussing charging, the EX30's 153 kilowatt DC quick charging limit permits the battery pack to be brought from 10% to 80% in close to 27 minutes at a quickly enough station. At home, proprietors can hope to go from level to full in around 8 hours through its 11 kilowatts level 2 AC charger. Furthermore, Volvo claims its little SUV can pull as much as a 2,000-pound trailer, however that will clearly come to the detriment of some reach. The EX30 is a little man. In fact, a subcompact SUV, its aspects are, I think, more much the same as that of a tallish hatchback. From heavily congested, it extends 166.7 crawls with a 104.3-inch wheelbase between. For setting, those figures place the EX30 scale squarely in the center of the Chevy Bolt TV and UV, however, at 61.2 inches tall and 72.3 inches wide, barring mirrors, the Volvo's position is lower and more extensive than by the same token. Unified inside plan. Outside, the EX30 is basically and abundantly etched, sharing components of its recognizable Scandinavian plan, dash from the Thor's sledge light mark to its upward tail lights, dash with any semblance of the bigger and XC90 and EX90. Notwithstanding, the Lodge steps in an exceptionally new heading for Volvo. Here, you'll find broad utilization of post-customer materials like the dashboard made out of reused window outlines, reasonably collected materials such as merino fleece and a general decrease of parts and hardware by means of a procedure that Volvo calls centralization. The unified idea concentrates the entirety of the stockpiling, gadgets and controls on a line drawn down the center of the lodge. Basically an expense-saving procedure saves materials, weight and, in particular, cash. However, Volvo's creators have utilized this restriction to make a cockpit that actually feels premium. Moving the window controls to the mid-control area and moving each of the front speakers to a dashboard soundbar diminishes how much inside wiring required, yet in addition opens up space on the entryways for enormous pockets. Single screen tech. The clearest illustration of the centralization idea is the huge focal showcase. The EX30 comes up short on conventional instrument group. Every single driving datum and the vast majority of the vehicle controls live on this 12.3-inch, in an upward direction arranged touchscreen. The infotainment is fueled by Google worked-in programming, which utilizes Google Guides as the essential root programming, Google's Play Store and administrations for streaming application downloads and Google Right Hand for voice control. Is the Volvo EX30 a decent vehicle? On the off chance that the Volvo EX97 seat SUV resembles a Scandinavian ranch-style home, the new EX30 is a popular condo in midtown Stockholm, more modest, more reasonable, yet entirely comparably upscale. It's additionally totally splendid and completely meriting being delegated the 2024 Car Wow Vehicle of the Year. On the off chance that you're thinking about the Volvo EX30, you ought to likely likewise add some comparably valued electric family vehicles to your shopping list, for example, the brilliant number 1, Kia Niro EV and Renault Megane E-Tech. It very well may be the littlest SUV in Volvo's lineup, however the EX30 has been given the same amount of affection from its planners as the greater SUVs, wearing a fresh outside and the normal moderate inside we've generally expected. Around, the Volvo EX30 feels impeccably at ease while cruising through the neighborhood. The low dashboard implies perceivability is perfect, regardless of whether the front points of support are a piece stout and the back window is minuscule. Notwithstanding, it's truly simple to put in a difficult situation and the light guiding means it requires little work to deal with heavy traffic. This is likewise assisted by one-pedal driving that will with carrying the vehicle to a standstill when you lift off, despite the fact that the slowing down isn't quite major areas of strength for so a few EVs. Generally great of everything is the manner in which the EX30 handles untimely obstacles. It's truly agreeable and there's no crashing or crashing through the lodge in the event that you hit a pothole or hindrance. It has the unwinding, refined driving experience of a greater, more rich SUV, on the motorway. That solace go on to the motorway, where the beautiful seats likewise help to make large miles a breeze. This is a little SUV but since it's agreeable and has a vaporous inside, you don't feel like you've been cooped up inside following a couple of hours in the driver's seat. There is a little wind and tire commotion to battle with, however it's nothing to gripe about. Especially in the more impressive execution variant, the engines answer immediately to you squeezing the choke, so assuming you want to pull off a surpass or move out into traffic finding a good pace is simple. The single engine adaptation isn't exactly as fast yet has sufficient ability to take care of business. Versatile voyage control comes as standard as a component of Volvo's pilot help framework. This likewise incorporates a path-keeping collaborator, which works effectively of keeping you in your path without being annoyingly meddlesome. On a twisty street. In spite of its unmistakable spotlight on solace, the Volvo EX30 is very great fun on a twisty street, especially in the event that you go for the presentation variant, since it has such a lot of force you can't resist the urge to grin while advancing out of corners. Notwithstanding this, in the event that you attempt to drive it like a games vehicle, the tires will battle for grasp and the body inclines a lot, which doesn't provide you with a great deal of certainty. This is a comparable issue for other little electric SUVs, for example, the brilliant number one, yet on the off chance that you need most extreme fun in the twists, the Kia Niro EV is your smartest option, albeit none are wannabe sports vehicles. Space in the rearward sitting arrangements. While front seat space is very great, those in the back need to forfeit some solace. Knee room specifically is tight, with just barely sufficient room for a 6-footer to sit behind another 6-footer. There are patterns toward the rear of the seats that will make it a piece simpler for more limited travelers, however it's still distant from roomy. It's a comparable story with shoulder room, which isn't terrible for a vehicle of this size, yet you won't have any desire to convey three travelers in the back for a really long time. Those in the center seat have respectable space for their feet, yet once more, knee room is somewhat of an issue. In spite of these grievances, headroom is fantastic, so it doesn't feel excessively claustrophobic, and the seats are entirely agreeable. In the event that you're conveying two or three young people on the school run, they ought to have not many grumblings with space in that frame of mind, until they get a development spray. Boot space. Sadly, boot space isn't awesome, all things considered. The general limit is 318 liters, which is as of now a few way behind different vehicles you can get at this sticker cost. However, this figure incorporates around 60 liters underneath the floor. Fortunately, that is a helpful space to store things you don't consistently utilize, and it's not difficult to place the bundle rack in there in the event that you really want to. The terrible news is that implies the genuine boot space is more similar to 260 liters. It has a helpful square space, and ought to be enough for a regular family's week after week shop, however athletic gear and ends of the week away will truly push its capacities.